You want to add life to your games, and animations are indeed the first step. My name is Anand, and in this video, we'll take a look at how animations are made in Unity, what they are, their settings, and everything else that you need to know. This is the first step to learning the Animator component, so check out the playlist below to master animations in Unity. So, animations are really what adds life to our games. Even something as subtle as moving the grass makes the whole thing feel more alive. And fortunately for us, there are tools to make this easy. Let's start off by discussing what exactly is an animation. In Unity, an animation is an asset that we can create, and it is a record of serialized data, which includes the variables that we see in the inspector, through time. Unity, just like most animation software, create keyframes to record the data on a particular field at a given frame of time. And a combination of these keyframes across time help us create various effects that bring about life. For example, we can move an object by creating keyframes of the position property in the transform component. Let's quickly do that. To create an animation, let's go to Window, Animation, Animation. It is best to dock it somewhere. Then we need to select the game object we want to animate and hit create to create an animation clip. We can save this clip somewhere in our project. Note, this is an asset in our project, which means we can reuse a single animation for multiple game objects if we want to. For example, some 3D characters may share the same humanoid rig, and we may want to share animations between them, particularly for mobile games where less resources are a goldmine. Now, this here is the animation timeline. We can click and drag the slider to move ahead of time. We can also see the current frame number we are at, and we can choose between different animations here. In order to start animating, we need to add keyframes. We can add keyframes in two ways. The boring but precise way to do that would be to click on Add Property, and then we can choose a component, and then choose a serialized field to animate. In this case, let's choose Position. This generates two keyframes at the beginning and the end, but doesn't do anything. We can then select a keyframe, move it across, and let's drag the slider to the keyframe, and let's change the position X to 5. Now it becomes red, which means there is a modification. Before we drag on the timeline again, make sure to save or key these changes by going to the field, right click, key all modified. Now if you play the animation, the box moves. This is a precise way to create keyframes and is only useful if we have to animate a single property. The better way to create keyframes is to enable the keyframe recording mode. Let's delete this key. Now we toggle this button. Once this button is enabled, Unity will keep track of any change in the serialized fields in the inspector and will add keys for it automatically. So now if we go to the beginning of the animation and set the position to something so that a keyframe gets created, then set it back to 0 to edit that keyframe so that the cube is at the starting position, move ahead in the timeline and then change it to 5. We can see the keyframes here, and then once we set this off, we can then move these keyframes as we like. To edit a keyframe, go to that frame and click on the button again and change the value in the inspector, and Unity will auto-update it for us. You can see that the animation works. However, this is not linear interpolation of data. We can confirm that by going over to the Curves tab, and we can see that this here is a smooth curve. We can also directly edit these keyframes and their tangents to edit this curve. If we want to make it linear, we can go back to the dope sheet and then select both keyframes and right click, set both tangents to linear. And you can see that the curve is no longer smooth. Now, if we go to the project, we can see that Unity has created an animator controller asset for us as well. Double clicking this controller will take us to the animator window, which is how Unity implements animations. We'll worry about that in the next video. But we can see that on entry, our animation is played, which means if you play the game, the cube will move based on the animation. We can see that the animation is looping. We can look at the settings of the animation by clicking on the animation asset. Here, if we disable loop time and then play the game, the looping gets stopped. Loop pause helps us with seamless animations This is useful only when we have rigging, but it does change the way the animation works. So be careful. And offset allows us to start the animation from a different time. Now, generally these are properties that you may not want to change, but it is indeed possible to do so. Now, there are many different ways of animating. In Unity, we can generally categorize it into frame by frame, 2D and 3D rigging, motion capture. Other animation types like motion graphics or stop motion is best to be done on other software like Adobe After Effects and later importing it as an MP4 file or something. Unless the animation has some dynamic element to it, then you do it in Unity. We'll also look at animating characters, state machine behaviors, and optimizing animations in later videos. So subscribe if you want more. And finally, let's take a look at the animation component, which is the legacy animation setup in Unity. We can select a game object, let's say a character, and add an animation component to it. This is the legacy system in place, and in my opinion, only go for it if you have frame by frame hand-drawn sprite sheets like the ones made in pixel art, or if you only have a single animation to play for this object, like this windmill. The main difference between the animation and the animator component is that the animation component is a list of animations and plays only one animation at a time. There would not be any blending happening at all unless we do some coding. This is ideal for hand-drawn 2D art. Also, it may be a bit faster compared to the animator component. The animator component is, however, flexible, works off of conditions, and supports blending, exit times, and all other stuff, which makes running complex animations a lot more easy. Now, we can add a list of animations to this list here and select a default animation. But before we do that, we have to go to the animation and mark the legacy label on it. To do that, select the animation asset, go to the inspector, we can click the three dots here, and go to debug mode. This means that we would no longer be able to use this animation inside the animator window. It would show an error. Play automatically starts the animation when the game starts or when the object is spawned. Animate physics lets the animation interact with physics. Culling type lets you choose to not animate the object when the object is not being rendered. For example, when the object is behind a wall or off the screen, always animate will always animate it. Based on renderers would cull based on the default animation pose. To trigger animations via code, create an object of type animation, get the component at start, and based on your logic, call animation.play function and pass in the name of the animation. We should call animation.play queued instead if we wish to call it only after the previous animation has stopped playing. We can also call functions to blend, crossfade, and stop animation as well. You can read more about it from the docs, link below. That sums up the basics of animation in Unity. Let me know how the video went. Make sure to check out the entire playlist for it. Take care, see ya, bye bye.